Okay, I'm presenting my screen to you so that all of you can see. They have told us not to present the whole window, but I don't have any option. I have so many things to be shown. Okay, so over here we have the questions that we are going to discuss. All of you can see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, now someone, Risham, would you please just explain, just give us a short introduction about what this chapter is all about and what historical facts that we have dealt with during reading this chapter while we were going through this chapter, several important historical aspects that we have come across, and what impact had this chapter created in your mind. Would you just give us a brief idea of what do you think about this chapter? Risham.
In the time of when Hitler killed when Hitler killed the Jews, at that time the Frank family, Anna Frank, along with her mother, father, mother Edith Frank, father Ottoman Frank, elder sister Margaret Frank were run away from Germany to Netherlands, where her father hid in her father's house for survive, and from there going to her school.
And up till then you have understood. Okay, Jishu, would you like to explain what are the various historical facts that we come across while reading the chapter?
Ma'am, Anne Frank is a girl. He started the writing on 20th June 1942.
You just tell me about the historical facts that we have come across. The historical, you can say the terms that we have come across while reading this chapter.
And the terms that are used in these chapters are like journals. Memoirs.
No, I'm saying about the historical terms that we have come across.
Ma'am, Holocaust.
Yes. Holocaust, yes. What is Holocaust?
Ma'am, mass killing.
Mass killing. Mass killing due to some specific reason. It was the Holocaust is called the specific reason killing genocide, which is done by the Nazis during the time of the Second World War. All the Jews, in the previous class also I've explained that Holocaust and concentration camp are very much related to this chapter. The two important historical terms that we come across are the Holocaust and the concentration camp. It is very much related to this chapter because Anne Frank later died in one of the concentration camps, and she was also a victim. She, along with her family, was a victim of the Holocaust system when Jews were being killed. Jews were being killed and sorted into ghettos. This is another historical terms I've mentioned in the previous class. What are ghettos? Ghettos are like small colonies where the Jews were kept. The Nazis or the Germans thought that the Jews were very formidable creatures. They are very much likable to be hated. So the Jews were kept in small colonies which were called the ghettos. Okay, G-H-E-T-T-O-S, ghettos. These Jews were then taken to different concentration camps. Concentration camps are where the Jews were usually killed or made to work like laborers, and no food, no healthy environment or hygienic conditions were given to these Jews. Okay, so this concentration camp is one of the leading propagandas laid by the Nazis during the time. Who are the Nazis? The follower of Hitler, the follower of German leader Hitler, are called the Nazis. that one of the major propagandas followed by the Nazis during the time of Second World War. Now, this is happening to a specific race, that all the Jews, millions and billions of Jews, were being killed in Germany and in Netherlands and Poland. This was not visible to the whole world to see. The world was only looking at the Second World War. The consequences of the Second World War were unknown to the world unless and until the war ended. After the ending of the war, the world came to know about this truth of the concentration camp, where the Jews were taken and they were killed, mass killed, by putting them inside a gas chamber. Okay, and poisonous gas was released in that chamber, and hundreds of people who were kept inside the chamber or pushed inside the chamber died by that process. Okay, so this is actually a mass killing. The concentration camps or the ghettos were mass killing centers where they died either of tuberculosis or of hunger or of the fumigation or the gas chamber. Okay, so Anne Frank and his family were hiding in her father's office building, in a small, you can say a small hideout, where they were hiding in the father's office building in an attic. Okay, and while they were hiding and they could not go out, she is writing the diary. Okay, not only the time when she is hiding, but also she started before the time when she is hiding. Now, as you will go through the whole diary, you will come to know about the hidings, about the attacks of the Germans and all this kind of thing, why they were hiding and what are the kinds of things that they are doing while they were hiding. So this diary was written mainly, the major portion of the diary was written when she was hiding from the Jews, from the Nazis, so that she cannot be caught and taken to the concentration camp. But it is later said that one of the people who knew this family betrayed them, and the Nazis found them in the hideout. And when they found the Frank family in the hideout and the other families which were hiding with them, they have been taken to the concentration camp. I have shown you in the PowerPoint presentation what is the concentration name, the name of the concentration camp. And though many died out of the gas chamber and fumigation and other things, but Anne Frank died of tuberculosis over there because of lack of food, lack of hygiene and many other kinds of things. She died of tuberculosis over there. And her body was even buried over there. The only member of the family who survived was Otto Frank from that concentration camp. Otto Frank is Anne Frank's father, who came back to their hideout in the place where they used to live in Netherlands, the father's office building. And when he revisited over there, he found the diary of Anne Frank. And when he went on reading through the diary, he felt, what is the language in which this diary was written? The original language in which the diary was written?
Dutch.
Yes, the language was Dutch, D-U-T-C-H, Dutch. So his father, when he went through the diary, when he started reading the diary, he realized this is very much relevant to whole world. This may be very much relevant to the whole world, to the adolescence period of this, of many children, and to the condition that the world faced during the time of Second World War. There was history in it. There was contemporary teenage mind in it. It was interesting. That is what her father felt. And he took it for publication. And when it got published, it went on increasing like a fire. The fame of Anne Frank went on increasing like fire, and it got published in several other languages other than Dutch, English, and many other languages. Now, there was many people who have been named in the diary. Afterwards, these people who were named in the diary and they were alive, if there is an aunt and she is alive, they were taken to many schools, many organizations, where they went and told the people about her life, about the life of Anne Frank. There were many schools who invited these people to talk to the students about how they lived and how they spent the time in the hideout. So there are many historical incidents and also some incidents which you can relate to as a teenager to Anne Frank. The school incidents, the historical, the love affair, the first case, all this kind of things you can very much relate to. And the history is not only history. World War has happened already, we all know. But the hatred that they're talking about, the social hatred, the social the kind of mentality that was there in the society at that time is something that is very relevant. We see this kind of mentality still in the society. There is racism. We have seen in US what happened, the Black Lives Matter protest and all this thing. This Black Lives Matter thing came out of racism. And what Germans did, what the Nazis did, was also a kind of racism. Okay, so you can easily relate the conditions of Anne Frank to your own life. Being an adolescent person, being a teenager, you can relate her school life, her love affair, her first kiss. That also you can relate, and you can also relate the social condition in which you are living, and the social condition in which Anne used to live. Okay, society only repeats itself. The history only repeats itself. There is a word, a phrase which says that history repeats itself. Same is the situation over here. We go on seeing that in some way or the other, we see the historical incidents repeating itself. So when, if you are asked that what are the various historical terms that you have come across while reading the chapter Anne Frank, then you are going to say the historical terms that we have come across while leading the chapter Anne Frank are Holocaust. We have come across Jews ghettos. We have come across World War II. We have come across concentration camps. We have come across Nazi organizations. So we have come across this kind of historical terms which are related to the story of Anne Frank. Okay. Now coming to the questions, first question would be, what makes writing in a diary a strange experience for Anne Frank? What makes writing in a diary a strange experience for Anne Frank? Now, all these questions and answers you're supposed to write down in your answer book. So be very careful when we are discussing the questions and answer.
Ma'am, repeat kijiye to.
Question, you cannot see the screen? Shivam, can you see the screen or not?
Yes, ma'am, now I can.
Yes. What makes writing in a diary strange experience for Anne Frank? Ishita, would you like to answer this question? Ishita, Ishita, you have microphone problem. Okay, Shoharta, would you like to answer this question? What makes writing in a diary a strange experience for Anne Frank?
Ma'am.
Yes, please try, then I'll explain.
Ma'am, it is... Ma'am, because he never written before in a diary.
Yes? Okay.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, CM.
One point is that he never written before in... write anything, and another is he thought who will interested to read a 13-year-old school.
Okay, so the answer that we are going to write down is we are going to say that writing, always remember, whenever you are starting an answer, take the link from the question. What is the question over here? What makes writing in a diary a strange experience for Anne Frank? So we would start the question as, writing in a diary became a strange experience for Anne Frank because. So we are taking the note from the question. Always do not forget to take the link from the question. Okay. Writing in a diary was a strange experience for Anne Frank because she has not written in a diary before, comma. Even she felt that there is no way that the others reading this document would be interested to read it afterwards. The others who would be reading this document would be interested in reading this document afterwards. Next point is that she even thought that she would not get a real friend at any time of her life who would be assigned to read this diary. As she was writing down her innermost feeling, which she thought that she is not going to disclose to anybody else. That is why she found that what is the meaning of writing this diary, because I could not show this thing to anybody. Okay, because I can only show these things to a very close friend. And if I'm not getting a very close friend, I'm not showing this diary to anyone. So what are the important points? Why it is a strange experience for him, for her? Because first, she's writing it for the first time. Secondly, she thinks that the experiences of a 13-year-old girl is not not interesting for the other readers who would be reading this one. And third is that she thought that she is never going to disclose the contents of this diary to anybody. So it's a very strange experience to write a diary when she knows very well that nobody is going to read this diary. Okay, so these are the three main points that you have to keep in mind. First is, I'm again repeating, first is she never wrote, that is why it was strange. Second is, as she thought that being a 13 years old, her experiences are not enough important to be discussed or read, important or interesting. And third is that she thought that she is never going to disclose the incidents that she is narrating in that diary with anybody else. That made the whole point. Okay. Next is, why does Anne want to keep a diary? Now she has said, tell us, yes. Yes, please say.
Ma'am, hum kya sun rahe hain? Ma'am, baad mein likhe.
Yes, you can. I will be giving you the video. You can just go to the video, click it, and then hear and write it down. Okay.
Ma'am.
Yes, please tell me.
Ma'am, in spite of her family and his friends, she cannot clearly share his feeling. So Andrew wanted to keep a diary so she can express his feelings in that diary, and she also gave the name diary as Kitty.
Okay, so you think that, one second please. Hello. Sir, ami class e royechi sir. Ami class er por call kore nichhi apnake, ha? হ্যাঁ স্যার, ওই 5টা নাগাদ বলে দিন, 5টা বা 4:30 নাগাদ। হ্যাঁ 3:30, কোনো অসুবিধা নেই। ঠিক আছে স্যার, ঠিক আছে স্যার। হ্যাঁ স্যার, ঠিক আছে স্যার, 3:30 করে। So the problem is that many of the students are having problem with the G Suite ID, especially the children, the 6 and 7 children. So we are assigning one meeting for the 7 children because they are the most drained out people I have ever met. The 7 children are so much drained out, they don't understand anything, they're so confused. Lot, even the teachers are confused, that is another thing. So we all are even confused, but still we want to go through this whole thing so that somebody, if there is somebody who can just
ma'am.
Yes
ma'am, Sahil ka wo Gmail login ho gaya ma'am, wo meeting mein aapka aane wala hai ma'am.
Okay
solve kar diya ma'am uska.
Okay, so what happens, why does Anne want to keep a diary? Number one, you should keep in mind her mindset. You would start like this: being an insightful child like Anne, being an insightful child like Anne, it became very difficult for her to get whatever she needed in a conversation from her friends and her family. She enjoyed spending time with her friends and her family by talking usual day-to-day things. But she felt that she is lacking something in those conversations. She was having conversation, she was having fun with her friends. But what did I say? Tum kya jaake tumhare friend se ye baat karte ho ki ye child labor ka problem ka hum kya kar sakte hai? Tumhara kya raay hai is baare mein? Do we talk like that to our friends? But the insightful mind, say for thing, I'm making an exaggerated example, but still, just think about the childhood of say Swami Vivekananda. He was an awakened person, so he must not be talking about or having a conversation about which one is better, is it PUBG or is it Free Fire. He must not be having that kind of a conversation. He must be having a very fruitful conversation, and usually in cases of this gifted child. They don't find enough topic with the common people to talk to. Whenever they're talking to normal or common usual people whose IQ level is lower than theirs, they don't feel satisfied. They don't feel that enough of their intelligence or enough of their intellect faculties are used in this conversation. And that is why she wanted to bring out all her inner feelings and her insights into something. That is why she wanted to keep a diary. Okay, so your answer would be, being a insightful child like Anne, she got easily bored with the conversations and found them uninteresting with her friends and her family. She had many inner thoughts and feelings which needed to be brought out. Full stop. For that outlet of her inner thoughts and feelings, which she thought that she is not going to disclose to any of her friends, whom she found to be not so close, she would start writing a diary. Full stop. She even named the diary just like a friend, so that she could get the feel of a real close friend while writing the diary. Full stop. So that would be the answer. I have the video recording going, so you would be getting the video, so you can play and pause again the answer to write it down in your answer book. Okay. Next question is, all of you can see the screen now.
Yes.
The training yesterday told us to just check with you once or twice while giving you the lecture, because maybe the screen has disappeared, because this is happening a lot. Blackout happens. Okay. So question number 3 is, why did Anne think she could confide more in her diary than in people? Why did Anne think that she could confide? First, somebody give me, what is the meaning of confide? What is the meaning of confide?
Confidence.
Having confidence in. That is confide. I confide on you people. That means whatever I tell you people, I have confidence that you are not going to manipulate my talkings, or you are not going to tell them to anybody else. That is why I could say that I confide in you. Having confidence in somebody is confiding on somebody. Okay. So it is, the question is, why did Anne think she could confide more in her diary than in people? Okay, somebody answer this question, please. Yes.
Ma'am, Annie believed that the paper has more patience than the people. So he usually takes the diary to share all his feeling, but he has also the friends, loving parents and elder sister, but he could not initiate intimate his experience to them. So he kept a diary to share all his feelings.
Okay, so we would write down the answer like this, that first of all, always remember to take the link of the answers, first few lines from the question. What did I say? Take the answers, first few lines link from the question. Yes?
Ma'am, Anne thought so because she doesn't have a true friend to confide in.
She keeps
the diary not to use it the way most people use. But she would treat it as her best friend.
Very good. See, in the class, if we have 20 to 25 students also, we have two perspectives of a question. Okay. And that gives us, in the society also, we have many kinds of people. Bahut tarah ke log hai. And each and everybody has his or her own perspective. Okay, say for example, when I am looking at the screen of the laptop, I have my own perspective, literal perspective. Okay, now if somebody is sitting beside me, she can get a different view of the laptop. Somebody who is sitting opposite to me will be having a different view of the laptop. Similar thing is about the society. Our position, our experience, our friends, our families, our intelligence and our mindset and our learnings give us our perspective. Nothing is objective. लोग बोलते हैं ऑब्जेक्टिवली देखो, दूर से देखो, समझने की कोशिश करो दूसरे के पैर, मतलब यू जस्ट पुट योर फीट इन सम पर्सन्स अदर्स शूज एंड ट्राई टू एक्सपीरियंस, बी एम्पैथेटिक, बट इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू प्लेस योर सेल्फ इन समबडी एल्सेस प्लेस, बिकॉज वी हैव डिफरेंट पर्सपेक्टिव्स ऑफ एवरीथिंग, एंड दैट इज वाई पीपल आर ऑलवेज सम judgmental about other people's views, because when they find that the other people are not agreeing to their perspective, they become judgmental. Okay, and that is why Anne could not confide to any people, but she could confide to the diary. Okay, so we would in the answer write that Anne thought that she could confide more in the diary than in people, because paper, she thought, paper had more patience than people. Paper had more patience than people. Full stop. There, she had many people around her. She had friends and loving family. But she thought nobody could be as close to her as to interpret her thoughts and feelings. Nobody was as close to her to interpret her thoughts and feelings. So she found the patience of the paper and non-judgmental attitude of anything that is non-living, non-judgmental part of anything that is not living, very approving. Very approving. That is why she could confide more in her diary and not in people. Okay, so what is the matter? She had many friends and family, but she found that paper is more patient than people, as paper is not going to judge you. Paper is not going to say that bahut boliya abhi ye same cheez pe bak bak nahi sunna hai mujhe. Sometimes, like our friends would tell, if you go on saying that this thing is that, this thing is that, this thing is that, and talking about the same topic, your friends would bahut sun liye is bare mein aur nahi sunna hai. That the paper is not going to say. The paper is neither going to judge you. The paper is not going to tell you that aur nahi sunna hai. So paper is more patient than people. That is why she has used the word that I confide more in the diary than in people. Okay. So coming to the next question. Next question is, why does Anne provide a brief sketch of her life? Why does Anne provide a brief sketch of her life? Who would answer this one?
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, Anne provide a brief sketch of her life. She feels that no one would understand her stories in her diary if she did not write about her life.
Yes, absolutely. Nothing more you need to write. Anne has given a brief sketch of her life before starting the diary, because she thought if she doesn't give a brief sketch of her life before starting it, nobody would be able to understand whatever is going on in her life. That is why the brief sketch was needed. So you are, I'm just again repeating the answer. Anne has given us a brief sketch of her life because she thought that if she straight away start writing the diary, nobody would be able to understand the incidents those were going on in her life, and also even a word from the writing. So she wanted to give a brief sketch of her life before she is starting the diary. Okay, question number two is, what tells you that Anne loved her grandmother? What tells you that Anne loved her grandmother? Yes, answer. Shomudip, have you joined? Let me see once who have joined, then I'll ask.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let me see who have joined. Adarsh is here. Farah, would you answer, please?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please answer.
Can we know her grandmother as a dream? When her grandmother died, she lighted a special candle for her grandmother in her birthday as a mark of respect for her.
Okay. And there is another sentence where we come to know about it. There is one more sentence which tells us that she is very fond of her grandmother.
Ma'am, the yes? celebration of the Anne Frank in 1942 was intended to make up for the others, and grandma's candle was lit along with the rest.
No, she has already, Farah has already told me this point. There is one more line.
Annie,
yes, please.
And her elder.
Yes, please, Shivam.
Ma'am, I will.
सब एक साथ बोलने से कैसे सुनाई देगा?
अरे मैं बोल रही हूँ ना भाई।
यस प्लीज से।
मैम इन द समर ऑफ 1941 व्हेन ग्रैंडमा फेल इल एंड हैड टू हैव एन ऑपरेशन सो हिज बर्थडे पास्ड ही बर्थडे पास्ड विद लिटिल सेलिब्रेशन।
नो not this line, any other line you found that which shows
that
Parthiv try.
Ma'am, because her parents went to Holland, leaving her with her grandmother.
No, not this one too. Now everybody over here, see, one second. You can see, all of you can see the screen. See over here. No one knows how often I think of her and still love her. No one knows how often I think of her and still love her. This is the sentence which tells us how much she loves her grandmother, because she is still thinking about her and she is not telling the fact that how much she loved her and how much she missed her to anybody else. Whenever we try to hide our pain or love for somebody, that is because our love is very pure in that case, very innocent in that case, and we don't want people to judge our love. That is why sometimes some people, you have also, you are grown up kids, you know that sometimes when you feel of something like this happens, that a boy loves a girl or a girl loves a boy, doesn't matter, and that person is not ready to confess his or her love to that boy or the girl. Maybe sometimes the reason is that person who is in love is not ready to confess is because that person thinks that my love is very pure and I don't want it back. Now this don't want it back is a complete shit thing. It is actually not the fact. Don't want it back is actually I don't want judgment from other people of whether she loves me back or not. The judgment portion comes up over here. Okay, so not confessing love or not confessing concern comes because of judgmental thoughts of other people around you. So Anne is also thinking that I am not going to be judged by other people because of my love for grandma is so pure and so innocent. Okay, that is why she says no one knows. Otherwise she could have easily told her mother that how much she missed grandma, but she is saying no one knows. How often means very often. How often is a way of saying very often I think of her and still love her. And that shows that if you go on thinking of somebody, that means you miss that person. Okay, so the answer would be, what tells us, first of all, you would say that the things that tell us, you would take the link from the question and you would say, the thing that tell us that Anne loved her grandmother are, number one, she had spent a long time of her childhood where she had stayed with her grandmom. Next point, she sacrificed her birthday parties for her grandmom. And number three, we have been told over here by her that she remembered her very often and still loved her a lot. So these are the main points. First of all, she has spent a huge time of her childhood with her grandmom. Secondly, she has sacrificed her birthdays because she was ill. And thirdly, because she often missed her and that shows her love towards that old lady. Okay, so these are the three points that you are going to keep in mind. Next question that is coming up is, okay, why was Mr. Kesing annoyed with Anne? Why was Mr. Kesing annoyed with Anne? What did he ask her to do? I would say who? No, wait. No, ma'am. I will say who will answer this one. This is a very easy one. So I want somebody to answer it. Shaumik would answer this one. Shaumik, answer this one.
Ma'am, what's the question?
The question, I'm showing you the screen. Yes, this is the question. You can see the screen.
Yes, ma'am. Why was Mr. Kiss my first one?
Yes, the first one.
Ma'am, bol raha hu, ma'am.
Why was Mr. Kesing annoyed with Anne? What did he ask her to do? Question mark.
मैम बोल रहा हूँ बोल के कहाँ चला गया?
हम गाइड खोलने बैठा है मैम.
No no no. He is checking the book. Yes, he is checking the book. Let him check the book, but I want him to say the answer. Because otherwise you people forget to give the, you don't give the answer and you don't revise the chapter afterwards. I feel bored going through my studies, so I can understand how well you people get bored with the studies. So,
ma'am, Mr. Kesing, yes, taught mathematics to author's class.
Okay. Then?
Ma'am, what did you do Oxford to? Ma'am, ye wala nahi aa raha, second wala nahi aa raha.
Tumne jo bola wo first wala ka answer bhi nahi tha. It's okay. Vedanta, would you try please? Why was Mr. Kesing annoyed with Anne?
Ma'am, because because Anne talked very much during the class.
Yes, because Anne used to talk a lot during the class. So we are not only going to write because Anne talked very much in the class. What did I say? Always take the link of the question while answering. Even while orally you are answering, you should take the link from the question and then pose it in the front sentence or the beginning sentence of the answer. Why was Mr. Kesing annoyed with Anne? If this is the question,
ma'am, you're
supposed to answer. No, the answer is already given. You're supposed
ma'am,
to answer.
Second part.
Say.
Ma'am, the teacher said and I'm to write an essay on chatter.
Only chatter or chatter box?
Oh, to ek hi baat hai.
And now apna naam bhul gaya.
Then I will also say chanta lagana aur fail karwa dena ek hi hota hai.
No, ma'am, fail se hota hai, chatter lagana teen se hota hai.
Similarly, chatter and chatterbox are completely two different things. Now listen very carefully. The answer would be, why was Mr. Kesing annoyed with Anne? The answer would be, Mr. Kesing was annoyed with Anne as she used to be a very talkative student in the class. Use different kind of words. If everybody is writing because she used to talk in class, you are going to write the answer like she used to be a very talkative student in the class. So the answer is Mr. Kesing was annoyed with Anne because she was a very talkative student in the class. Okay, next part of the answer, what did he ask her to do? He has asked Anne to write an essay on the topic chatterbox as a punishment for talking in the class. He or Mr. Kesing asked Anne to write an essay on the topic the chatterbox as a punishment for talking in the class. Okay, coming to the question number 2, how did Anne justify her being a chatterbox in her essay? How did Anne justify her being a chatterbox in her essay? I would like Diporna to answer this one, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please answer.
Annie justified her being a chatterbox in her essay by explaining that it is due to her mother, who also very talkative and nobody would like him.
Very good. Very well said. So, I would add just one more point and the answer would be, Anne, first of all, you're going to take the link from the question again. I'm saying, Anne justified her being a chatterbox in the essay by two major points. Firstly, she said that it is a trait of a student to talk, to express themselves. It is a trait, T-R-A-I-T, trait. Trait means feature or characteristic. Trait of a student to talk in the class, to express themselves, And secondly, Anne explained that as her mother also have a criteria or a characteristic of talking too much, she has inherited this trait from her mother. She has inherited, as her mother also have a characteristics of talking too much, that is why she, being the daughter, has inherited the trait, T-R-A-I-T, trait from her mother. Got it? So first of all, you are going to write there. There were two main points, then firstly and secondly. Like this, you are going to write down the answer. Try to express your answer in a way like nobody is doing. If you just write the answer and leave it, remember this is literature. So they are also going to just give some marks and leave it. But if you want to get a good marks and get a full marks, always in the board exams, try to innovate new things in your answer. Try to post some words, some new words. Now, don't give out some words which the meaning of which word you know don't know at all. Don't use unknown vocabulary, but make your vocabulary strong so that you can use new words to write your answers and also your creative writing section, so that the reader, the teacher who is reading, say for 300 copies, she would get something new while she or he is reading your copy, and that new would give you the marks. Okay, because teachers usually get bored seeing the same answer all throughout. Now, if you give them something new, they will also give you something more. What the point? So please keep this thing in your mind. Please arrange your answer very properly. Keep your handwriting very neat. Handwriting being neat is a major criteria while you're writing your board paper. Your handwriting should be very neat and clean. If also you don't have a good handwriting, try to make it neat. If also it's not good, try to make it neat. Okay, coming to the next question. Why do you think Mr. Kasing was a strict teacher? Or no, not why do you think, the question is, do you think Mr. Kasing was a strict teacher?
No, ma'am.
Do you think Mr. Kasing is a strict teacher? Now I will tell you who will answer this one. Shrija, Shomodeep is there. Shomodeep, answer this one.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you think that Mr. Kasing was a strict teacher?
Kasing was not a strict teacher.
Why?
Because if there is another teacher, she or he will scold or beat her, or simply she can ignore her. Give her homework, give her a chatterbox and homework or a.
Okay. Anybody else want to answer this question?
Mr. Kasing was a strict teacher. If he was a strict teacher, then he will going to beat her, Anna, or scolded her. He did not allow to talk in the class after.
Okay. Now we after will try to
good
pose
essay
this
on
question.
Chatterbox and second time.
Okay, Shivam, we will try to pose this question like this. The question is, do you think Mr. Kasing was a strict teacher? Question mark. So we are going to first put on, no, we do not think that Mr. Kasing was a strict teacher. No, we do not think that Mr. Kasing was a strict teacher. Full stop. Because we do not find him to be either scolding or beating Anne in this case. Because we find her giving her several kind of writing assignments which the teacher knew and was good in. Now, if somebody knows that Sahil is a very good runner, he is an athlete. Now, he has been given a task as a punishment to roam around in the field. Would it be a punishment for him? Obviously, no. If he has been given a punishment to run around in the field, it would not be a punishment for him. Okay, similarly, the teacher and the other teachers, we have previously come across all the teachers loved Anne. So Anne is, the other teachers are also aware of the fact that Anne is good in writing and she has been given the punishment to write. So it is not a punishment at all. It is a way that the teacher is giving the child to express. So we are going to write that no, Mr. Kasing was not a strict teacher because he is not giving Anne any kind of scolding or any harsh punishment. Whereas we find him giving Anne a punishment of writing an essay which she is already good at. If he wanted to give, this was the answer, okay? Now, I'm just explaining. If he wanted, if he was
a strict teacher, he will not laugh in his, that also
we may include that, and moreover we find him laughing at the end of the story where Anne is making fun of him. If he was a strict teacher, he wouldn't have enjoyed the fun that Anne has made on him. Right, and he knew very well that being a maths teacher, Anne was not good in maths. He could have given Anne homework of maths, but what did he give? He has given Anne to write an essay. That shows that he was not a strict teacher at all. He just wanted the outlet of Anne to be more conspicuous, more important. Got it? Can you understand what I'm saying? Could you just relate to the fact? Agar strict hoga, to wo maths ka homework dega na? वो इंग्लिश वाला होमवर्क क्यों देगा? बिकॉज ही नोज दैट एन इज गुड इन राइटिंग, दैट इज वाई इट विल गिव एन एन आउटलेट टू एक्सप्रेस हर सेल्फ, दैट इज वाई दे आर गिविंग एन दिस काइंड ऑफ अ पनिशमेंट. ओके, सो कमिंग टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, द लास्ट वन, व्हाट मेड मिस्टर केसिंग अलाउ एन टू टॉक इन क्लास? व्हाट मेड मिस्टर केसिंग अलाउ एन टू टॉक इन द क्लास? सो हु वुड एक्सप्लेन दिस आंसर टू मी?
I try to.
Yes, please.
Annie was able to justify her talkative nature every time. She was punished by Mr. Kasing. Mr. Kasing accepted the fact that Annie would always be that way, and she allowed it to talk in class.
Could you just post some examples from the verse essay that she has written?
Yes.
Yes. Anybody else?
Ma'am,
Yes.
Ma'am.
Yes, please say.
Ma'am.
No, the other body who said that, ma'am, kya main bolu? Please let her say.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, please say.
Question is, what made Mr. Kasing allow Annie to talk in class?
Yes.
So the answer will be, Mr. Kasing allowed Annie to talk in class because when Mr. Kasing gave him punishment to write an essay on Chatterbox, several times he gave to write an essay based on Chatterbox. And Annie was good in writing in English and she completed very well. And in the last essay, she write a poem and write a poem on the by reading is Mr. Kasing was impressed and he laughed on him and so he allowed him to talk in class.
Okay, so I will just give my answer to you now. My answer would be Mr. Kasing allowed. Okay, if the question is in present tense, do not forget to make it in past tense while you're writing the answer. What is the question? What made Mr. Kasing allow Anne to talk in class? So the answer would be Mr. Kasing allowed Anne. Please put the microphone off. Some of your microphones are on. Please mute it off so that I can say it easily and all of you could hear. Mr. Kasing allowed Anne to talk in class because many a times he has given Anne an essay to write on talking in class, on a girl who talks in class, whom he called a chatterbox. And every time Anne came up with new points supporting her talking in class. Every time what Anne has done, she has actually brought out some points which would support her talking in class. Okay. And every time Anne came up with some points supporting her talking in class. Full stop. That these points were highlighted even more in the last essay. Quack Quack said the what was the name of the essay? Quack Quack
said Mr. Chatterbox.
So this was more highlighted in this Quack Quack said Mr. Chatterbox, when actually Anne took the writing to a level of a satire. S-A-T-I-R-E. What is a satire? First, listen to the answer, then I'll explain what is a satire. Anne has taken it to the level of a satire and made fun of him only, that is, made fun of Mr. Kasing only. Full stop. When Mr. Kasing went on reading these essays, Mr. Kasing got a clear idea of Anne's intelligence and creativity, which impressed him a lot and which made him allow Anne to talk in class after that. Now, what Anne wrote at the end, was a satire. What is a satire? When you want to say something negative about something or somebody, but in a different casual way. Okay, I don't know how many of you have seen the Bengali movie called Gopi Gain Bagha Bain. How many of you have seen the English short film, the animation film called The Inside Out? The animation film called Inside Out, the animation film like Toy Stories. If you delve deep into the stories, you will have a smell of satire. Whenever different aspects of a society or some person you want to make fun of, you write a satire. When people will read, they won't understand that they are getting mocked. But if you delve deep into it, you will understand that you are the person who are getting mocked in that story or in that film. As for example, Anne wrote that there was a father duck who killed the duckling. Who is a duckling? The baby duck is called a duckling. Okay. So in the story, in the poem, what does Anne explain? Anne said the father duck kills the little duck for talking too much. Okay. Now, if you just read the story, you will only find it as a story. But if Mr. Kasing reads it, he will understand that he is actually playing the role of the father duck over in the essay, as he is constantly punishing Anne, who is the little duck. So it's a kind of satire that Anne has made on Mr. Kasing, where you narrate a story to make fun of somebody's behavior or somebody's concept. That is what a satire is. If you want to know more about satires, you can definitely search in internet to know about it. Now, I have discussed all those questions which were there in our textbooks. But there are some more questions which has come in our previous year's question papers. Okay, so today, as we don't have more time, we will just leave it over here with the questions of the textbook. In the next class, before we go on to the PISA work, because we will be doing one PISA class also every week. So before we go on an activity, I have planned one activity for the next class. So before going on to the activity, we will also discuss a few more extra questions from this chapter, which are from the previous year's question paper. So I'll just stop this recording and also stop sharing.
We have to write thinking about text.
No, you don't have to write it now.